My question goes to you, Kiran, is that using traditional project management, which is taking 12 months to deliver the first instance of the functionality to the user, how do you make sure that the user who had requested for the functionality still needs it? Still needs it?
Okay.
12 months down the line? My question to you, Mohit, would be that using Agile in an industry like ours, specifically in India, how do you cater to fixed price projects where there is a demand by the client to help us, you know, project a fixed price amount as we go ahead for any kind of development? Understanding Agile, usually estimation is by story pointing, so I'll be interested to hear your thoughts about it. Thank you.
Sure.
Okay, now answering your first part of the question, where PMP should be used or Agile should be used. Okay, it's a vast area. It depends on the situation to situation. But the most thumb rule I can say is that if it's a fixed cost type of project, don't go with Agile. You will end up in a problem there. Because it keeps on changing. You give liberty to the stakeholder to change things. Okay. Yes, if it is man and material, you're billing him, better go for Agile. Let him give what number of changes he wants. Keep on doing those changes. That's the best option. Lifelong chalte rahega. Okay. Now, what was your question? Can you repeat that question for me?
The question specifically to you was that in a traditional project environment which has a waterfall life cycle using PMP concepts, where we get a set of requirements agreed upon with the user or group of users, get their complete approval on it, and 12 months down the line when we deliver the first instance of that working software, how do you make sure that this is still relevant? 12 months is a long time in the industry.
Now, first thing, when you said 12 months is actually a very long time, you should not do something like that in PMP, please. If you are, hold on, hold on, let me answer. There may be a situation in the organization where a project like that came, but it's a wrong way of handling project then. Okay? Your stakeholders should be involved in regular basis, not day to day basis, sometime, give it a duration. After every duration, keep him posted with the plans that we are here and what this is what we are doing.
I'm quoting something from an industry data source now. The average length of ERP implementations across the globe is 3 years. The first instance is delivered in a year and a half. How do you make sure that the customer still wants that? We have spent 12 months delivering something and we have done a good job. I'm not saying we have not followed all the processes. But once that has been done, your group of users might be wanting something completely different. So all you have done for those 12 months, who knows?
See, in this situation, if you're talking about ERP, okay? The ERP are very standard products available in market. They know what market needs. If you go after 12 months and you tell them this is the ERP, and he's in production industry and you show him something from marine industry, then it's a total failure. Okay. Now, if you go with the production industry ERP over there and give him a production industry ERP, okay. Now, when he gave specifications to you, the requirements, you drafted those requirements, you took a sign off of that. Okay. You produce him with whatever use cases or prototype or whatever explicit things you gave to him, that person. So those things are there. Now, if he says that after 12 months, I don't need it, right?
That's I'm not trying to be argumentative, so please bear with me. You must be the only industry in the world where we penalize a user to change their minds. When you are building a house for yourself where you intend to live, suppose you decide to change the color of the floor 6 months into the process and your person says, no, you have to wait for 12 more months, send me a change request, and only then can you change anything in the house. What's the point? We are basically delivering a product that could be used by somebody in the end. If the user is not going to use it, your project is failed in any case. So unless the user is allowed to make that change and make it usable, what's the point? I think you quoted an example earlier about the number of requirements that are not used once they are delivered. I personally experienced a lot of that in ERP also. That companies build features and eventually never use them. And I think that is a question which Agile has tried to answer.
Now in this situation, if you say that if you want to change the color of your floor or whatever house in 6 months, whereas the deliverable is supposed to be given in 12 months, okay, that doesn't mean that you don't take the change. You take the change, do the proper impact analysis of that, put it to user. Okay, earlier you asked that the wall should be somewhat diagonal, now you want it to be a pure vertical wall, I'll change it. But because of this, these are only impacts. If you want, we can go with that. The impact may change your schedule also, may change your cost also. Put it to the customer.
That is the point.
Huh?
That is what Agile says. That
that is what PMP says.
No, excuse me, let me come to my point.
That is what PMP says.
PMP says that if you have a 12-month long project, plan it to the last level of detail for the 12th month, elaborate progressively. Elaborate progressively. What no. Agile says is create a high level plan, but do not get into the details.
Hold on. It says elaborate progressively when the requirements are not clear. Only then.
Right.
If the requirements are very clear, I want a diagonal wall. Plan it accordingly, go ahead. But if he says instead of diagonal, now make it vertical, I will make it vertical. I will pass it to the change control board. They will do the impact analysis. The impact is presented to the customer. Customer says, okay, I am ready to bear that impact, go ahead. I will do it vertical. No issues.
When was the last time you worked on a project that didn't have at least 10% change requests?
There are more than 10% change requests.
Exactly. Then why? What then? Make it up. I mean, this is turning into a discussion on Agile.
Right. So, can I answer your questions which you had? See, again, I would say that you have mentioned a very good point that Mohit, Agile doesn't focuses upon iterative changes or dynamic changes in the plan. Rather, it focuses, it is more driven by the customer's priorities and as and when customer comes up. And that is what I have been trying to say. When the customer comes up with something and based upon his priority, today he said that I want to wear black shoes, tomorrow he says I want to wear brown shoes. And I said, okay sir, no issues, let's have a brown shoes, instead of asking him to have a change request based first. Number one. Number two, you said that, Mohit, how will the fixed priced project in which there is no change accepted, how will the agile methodology be helpful in that? Since you are working in agile, I believe I just mentioned one of its approaches and that was early release of the project. What happens is that I have a fixed price project of let's say 6 months. I know it's going to be completed in 6 months. But there is no change as such, but still I involved more team members, meeting the customer expectations, and then I made sure that before 6 months I am ready to release that project or release that product or deliver that service. So Agile says that if you follow this approach, if you dynamically change yourself or mold yourself according to customers' expectations, you would be able to achieve more benefit out of it. And what else you want? You said your house would be ready in 2 years, I made it available to you in 1.5 years. You said that tomorrow morning I want color as white on the walls and tomorrow I said blue, I said okay. Agile doesn't say that there is no process behind it, but it trains you in such a way that you are dynamic to changes and you implement it in such a way that you make the returns out of it as well without disturbing the budget and every other resource constraints. And that is the beauty of Agile which I have been, you know, focuses upon in my discussion.
But I have a point over here. If you keep on changing this, it's not going to affect your budget.
That is the beauty.
Now, for example, I painted my wall with white, suddenly you change, now change it to red. There is a cost involved.
No, yes, but that is the proof from the client, because when we started off with the project, we said that, sir, if there would be any iterative changes, there would be a cost involved in it and you would have to bear it. Client said, okay, I'm ready, but I just want to make sure that if I said that by tomorrow it should be done, it should be done. I said, okay, I'll include more resources and I'll make it happen. And that's what I did.
Now, again, if you put more resources, just hold on, if you put more resources, what are you doing? Fast tracking it?
No, making dynamic changes.
Right, somewhere. So indirectly, it's boils down to the same thing.
That's what I'm saying. I think that is what I was trying to say. That yes. Agile pretty much caters to similar concepts. It just focuses on short-term planning.
Right.
Answering your question about introducing change and changing the cost, I think that's a point that you have made. I just want to elaborate something on that if that's okay. Even in Agile, there is a concept of managing cost. There is a concept of managing your capacity. Never take up more than the capacity. So even if you have introduced 3 new change requests into a sprint, you will also be pushing out something out of that sprint.
Right.
Your cost will remain the same.
Right. Absolutely right. It goes. See, now just for sake of debating, you have to debate, okay, somehow.
So end of the day, you agree that Agile is okay.
I never said Agile.
You said it.
I have to take a stand on it.
Sir, it does not.
Okay. See, the debate is not over. Okay. If you ask questions that you don't take a neutral stand and take out, what are aspects, believe me, it will be totally different.
No, the debate is still on, sir.
Okay, I have a question which is probably extension of the questions which he asked about the usability of where you want to use Agile and PM. Is your take different on the if the projects are pure development projects or maintenance and support kind of project? So in that case, is your take different or you see it's all generic everywhere you can use either one or you know a mix of it, how it is?
I would say the take would be same in both of them, because Agile caters any kind of changes which are from the customer's expectations into your plan without disturbing the whole bunch of it and delaying it. So even if you are developing a software, need to deliver it to the customer in the middle of it, in let's say 2-3 months, comes up and says that you have to have this change. You are dynamic to it. Your team is aware of it. You planned a meeting, made that change. Done. In case of IT services, if you have to implement, let's say, configuration management process in place, customer said, I just want data center CIs to be included in CMD. You said, okay. Tomorrow customer says, no, I want EUC stuff as well. That is laptops and desktops as well as a CI. In CMDB, you said, okay, fine, we will include SCCM as a tool, integrated with CMDB and load the data. You are adapted to change. So this holds good both in case of service delivery and, support delivery and also in product delivery.
I'll put one more.
And also, next sub-question to that is about the length of the project. If it is, my project is 3 years project and my project is 6 months project.
See,
in both the cases, again, it is same or...
I'll answer that. See, it doesn't matter actually. It depends on your organization. Number one, is your organization following Agile methodology or PMP methodology? If they are following Agile, no matter how much head you break in front of your management, they are not going to accept. They will say, go with Agile. And if they are following PMP, no matter how much you try to explain that Agile is good, they will still follow PMP. But now, the point comes about choosing a project. As I said, in fixed cost project, please try to avoid Agile. The reason is that you want to keep things in your control. In case of Agile, if it's billing type of project where you're billing per resource or something like that, give that liberty to the customer because he gets maximum value out of that project. With every delivery, he's seeing that something is delivered. And he's happy with that because he can go and implement it in his system and he can start using it. In case of PMP, he may get that thing 2 months down the line rather than getting it in 2 weeks. Okay? So it totally depends from situation to situation, depends on your organization. And last thing, also look for your effectiveness and efficiency of delivery. Okay? When you talk about efficiency, what type of processes? Agile never says that don't do this. Okay? Agile says that we are not following any processes, but that doesn't mean that don't follow processes. Agile never says that don't do documentation. It never says that. You need to do some basic documentation in your water project. Okay, follow those documentation, do it. And then whether you go this one, PMP or you go with Agile, it doesn't matter.
I have one as I am continuously hearing about change coming from client and what the importance for dynamism and accepting the changes. My basic question is, during the sprint, do you accept changes?
I'm sorry?
During the sprint, do you accept changes?
During what?
Sprint.
Yes, we do accept changes. But the implementation of those changes...
You shouldn't accept changes.
No. Just hold on. When we say changes, it doesn't say that traditional change which we talk about. It's like, you know, the requirements which are coming up. We cater those requirements and ensure that they are implemented according to the requirement of the customer. That's it.
Yeah. I mean, when the changes dynamism you are talking about, the client expectation. As in during the 15 digit, he has mentioned change the color of the wall. In the 15 digit, client expects to change the color of the wall. Do you accept that in that sprint?
See, I would push that actually. This is a very tricky question.
Yeah, but just one thing, just give me the meaning of this word sprint. I don't know that.
See, but there are two differences.
It's iteration. Iteration is a 15-day sprint, which is like in Agile, we deliver a sprint.
Okay.
So, what he asked actually, do we accept any change request between the sprint? There are two different philosophies, and I would like to highlight that actually, that depends on the condition. See, there is a debate on fixed price Agile, and I say that Agile is best for fixed price also. See, why the wrong concept here has been discussed is about we need to involve cost. No, we don't involve any additional cost. What we will do, we will cut down something, we will compromise some other features for some new features. That is what happens in Agile actually. And it's a very simple philosophy where we actually, if we want to buy a car,